Objects. Hello everyone, welcome to the new lesson in the course CA Foundation Business Correspondence and Reporting. This is something about me and let's get started. Chapter 2, Sentence Types, Part 2. So the learning targets for this particular lesson are types of sentences and parts of sentences. Let us start with the parts of sentence first. First one is the subject. So the person or the thing about which something is stated is the subject of the sentence. For example, Rita is writing a letter. So here Rita is the subject and is writing a letter is a predicate. Predicate is the part of a sentence that tells us something about the subject. So Rita will be the subject, is writing a letter will be the predicate. Next, direct object, a person or a thing that is affected by the verb of the subject. Okay, by the action of the subject, a person or a thing that is affected. So here, what will be your direct object? Rita is writing the letter. So what is the verb over here? Writing. So who is writing a letter? Rita. So here direct object will be Rita. Indirect object is a person or a thing that the action is done to or is done for. So Rita is writing a letter. A letter will be the indirect object. Next, parts of a sentence, number 5, the object of preposition. So object of preposition is a noun or a pronoun that completes the meaning of the sentence. Okay, verb is a part of speech that describes an action or occurrence or indicates a state of being. In every sentence, the most important word is the verb itself. Next is phrases, group of related words that make some sense but not complete sense. For phrases and complements, I'll request you all to see sentence types part 1 because there I have covered both of these in detail. Next, complement, a word or group of words that completes the meaning of a subject, that completes the meaning of an object or a verb is called as a complement. So how are you going to distinguish between indirect object and the object of preposition? Object of prepositions comes immediately after the preposition. Okay. Indirect object does not come immediately after the preposition. Indirect object is followed by the direct object, whereas the direct object does not follow this principle. Types of sentences, based on the function we have 4 types, based on the structure we have 4 types. So based on the function we have declarative, imperative, interrogative and exclamatory. Based on structure we have simple, compound, complex and complex compound. So let's get started based on the function. First is declarative. Declarative sentences can be positive or negative statements. It is a statement. Okay, this is very important. A proverb, a universal truth or a suggestion. Examples on each type, these are on page number 2.8 in your study material issued by ICAI. But here, see, there's a simple sentence. We can say, it is 6 o'clock. This is a declarative sentence. Please come in. This is also a declarative sentence. Or we can say, Monday comes before Tuesday. This is also a universal truth. Or if a suggestion you can give is, please eat your food on time. This is a suggestion. Okay? So, all of these are the examples of declarative sentences. Imperative sentence means here they express an order or a command, an advice, a request, a proposal or a suggestion. For example, shut up. Or we can say, please leave the class. Or we can say, may I come in? Okay, so all these things will be imperative. No, not may I come in, it will be come in. Come in will be imperative, not may I come in. Next, interrogative. Interrogative questions, they ask questions. Okay, interrogative sentences means they are questions. A verb always followed by a WH word while framing a question sentence and they end with a question mark. All the questions basically are interrogative sentences. As I told you earlier, here it will be please come in, here it will be may I come in. Okay, may I come in will be there. Where were you? What is your name? All this will be coming in interrogative sentences. Next is exclamatory. They express strong feelings or emotions such as joy, sorrow, regret, surprise, wonder, etc. Alas, he is dead. Or, wow, so beautiful. Or, we can say, hooray, we won. So, all of these are exclamatory sentences. They end with an exclamation mark. Next, based on the structure, first one is simple sentence. A simple sentence structure consists of only one subject, one predicate and one finite verb. Now, what is finite verb? I request all of you to please refer to part 1 of sentence types. There I have elaborated the types of verbs properly. Examples for this will be, you will be finding it on page number 2.9 in your study material. For compound sentence, it is a composed of two or more independent clauses. The clauses are joined by coordinating conjunction, a comma, a semicolon and even a colon. Coordinating conjunction will be something that joins two words or two sentences. And, but, not only but also, all of these are used in compound sentences. Or also a comma can be used, a semicolon can be used and also a colon can be used. Next, complex sentences. A complex sentence has one main clause and one or more dependent clauses. Dependent clauses are also called as subordinate clauses. Complex compound. It has two or more independent clauses plus one or more dependent clauses. See, simple sentence has one subject, one predicate, one finite verb. Compound has two or more independent clauses which are joined together. Complex has one main clause and one or more dependent clauses. Complex has two or more independent or main clauses plus one or more dependent clauses. Examples for this you will be finding in page 2.10 in your ICAI study material. Thanks a lot for watching, people. Please get curious, find all the answers of all the questions that you have. Be the best in whatever you are doing. Do rate, review and recommend my course if you are liking it. Share this course if you feel that this can be beneficial for somebody. You can ask all of your doubts in the comment section below and I'll be happy to answer. I'm really sorry I could not cover all the details in this lesson because of the time constraint, but I request you all to please go through the book Wren and Martin, which will be helpful for you to clear your grammar basics. And if after referring to that you read my you go through my lesson, it will be helpful for you. Also, you can as I've told you in the overview lesson, that you all also have to read my lessons with your ICAI study material or any of the, or even you can look out for the CS foundation study material while referring to my lesson. It will be helpful for you. Thanks for watching.